Gentlemen and ladies. Ladies and gents. Good top of the morning to top of the afternoon, bottom of the evening, whatever situation you find yourself in. You just gotta go back there, don't you? That's how it always be. That's how it always be, ladies and gentlemen. That's how it always be. Just you and me. It's so wonderful to be. Ladies and gentlemen, it is so wonderful to be around, ain't it? Me. It can't be more than just incredible. It's incredible.
You bring out the man in me with your style of love. Inseparable. Yes, that's what we are.
All right, we're going to let Natalie be in my background, you know, because she's like a flower to a tree, like, you know, words to a melody of love. I'm going to not let her continue with another song because we ain't going there right now. Ladies and gentlemen, just here to go ahead and let you guys know we're going to be starting up our debt program, removing debt from people's accounts, getting them their credit, pay attention, tax credits to offset the debt, proving that there is no debt. I promise you, this was supposed to be done a long time ago. I just didn't have the time to put the effort behind it. And so now I have the staff who have an understanding. They've been trained enough to understand, and we have the document. There's only one document that will be sent out to creditors and the credit reporting bureaus, and everything else will be, this is all done under the sole proprietorship of the EeoN Foundation, but it will be done through SACOM, but it will be done under the sole proprietorship of the EeoN Foundation. Basically what I'm saying is they'll have to deal with me. For the sake of you all, I am tired of you all having to struggle. I'm tired of you all having to argue. Tired of you all having to receive these letters from these attorneys and to go into these courts and not know what to say. Tired of the courts and these attorneys telling you that you owe money. Ladies and gentlemen, since 1933, there has been no money. I don't think you all heard me. Since 1933, we have been in a state of national emergency. I'm going to show you one more time. This law has not changed. It has not been rewritten. There have been amendments, but none of the amendments significant enough to change the status quo. This is the Gold Repeal Act, ladies and gentlemen. This is known as Joint Resolution. Many of you have heard of it. Joint Resolution, June 5th, 1933, or... let's give you the title of the act, the Uniform Value of Coins and Currencies of the United States. To assure the uniform value of coins and currencies, that's all coins and currencies of the United States. Many of you simply don't realize that your promissory notes are construed as coins and currencies of the United States. And because you didn't know that, you're sitting up here trying to do closed checking accounts, trying to do ACHs, and you're trying to do all these other things, and you're writing all these bonds and notes and everything. Why are you doing that? Why are you flooding the market with worthless junk? The original promissory note that was accepted, that is what the monies are. When it was accepted, it became monies. But you didn't realize that. So let me go ahead and explain it to you. Again, the law that we're showing you is still law. It is the act of June 5th and 6th, 1933. Has not changed. Now, technically, it's just the act of June 5th, but this is showing you the dates, June 5th and 6th, because that's over the period in which it took place. Pay attention. every provision contained in or made with respects to any contractual obligation. Congress has already let you know that that's what it means when it says obligation. An obligation is a contract, it's an agreement, which purports to give the obligee, the creditor, the right to require payment in any coin or currency or amount of money of the United States. Is against public policy. Erie Railroad versus Tompkins, 1938, the Supreme Court said that we are under a system of public policy since this right here, since March 9, 1933 and June 5th, 1933, we're under a system of public policy because we're in a national emergency. I apologize, ladies and gentlemen. Many of you should have known this, been yelling it and shouting it and screaming it. No such provision, contract, shall be contained or made with respects to any contract hereafter incurred. Nobody can do it. This act has not been repealed. This is not HJR 192. This is Joint Resolution June 5th and 6th, 1933, or the Gold Abrogation Act, or the Gold Repeal Act. Well, it's technically the Gold Clause Repeal Act is what they refer to it as. Every obligation or every contract heretofore up to this point and hereafter, anything after this incurred, whether or not such a provision is contained in or made with respects thereto, shall be discharged upon payment dollar for dollar in any coin or currency, which is at the time of payment legal tender for public and private debts. So let's show you what is legal tender for public and private debts according to Congress. We're gonna make this a little bit larger so y'all can see, because we don't want y'all straining your eyes. Pay attention. Shall be equal to the face value of the direct obligations contract of the United States, so deposited as securities, and when issued against the security of notes, your promissory notes, drafts, bills of exchange, and bankers' acceptances acquired under the provisions of this act. It has to be done in accordance with the provisions of this act. So what is it? What's the provisions of this act? This act says upon deposit with the Treasury of the United States, any contractual obligation of the United States or any notes, promissory notes, Federal Reserve notes, pay attention, circulating notes, national bank notes, all notes, drafts, bills of exchange, bankers' acceptances acquired under the provisions of this act, the Federal Reserve Act, the Federal Reserve Bank, you, any Federal Reserve Bank making such a deposit in the manner prescribed by the Secretary of the Treasury. What manner did the Secretary of the Treasury prescribe? What manner? You guys don't know? You don't know. Well, let's show you what manner the Secretary of the Treasury prescribed, because some of y'all just simply don't understand what's going on here. When required to do so by the Secretary of the Treasury, each Federal Reserve agent may act as agent for the Treasurer of the United States or of the Comptroller of the Currency or both for the performance of any feature. Sorry, got to get rid of that. For the performance of any function which the Treasurer or Comptroller of the Currency may be performed upon or called upon to perform in carrying out the provisions of this paragraph. Pay attention. Federal Reserve Operating Circular Numeral 10. Why? Pay attention. Subject to such limitations, restrictions, and regulations as the Federal Reserve Board may prescribe, any Federal Reserve Bank may make advances to any individual, partnership, or corporation on the promissory notes of such individual. Ta-da! Now, pay attention. These are the regulations. Federal Reserve Operating Circular Number 10. That's the regulation. But they're operating in whose capacity? The capacity of the Treasury. Sorry about that. And by acting in the capacity of the Treasury, these are the manners prescribed by the United States Treasury because they are acting in their stead. Now, what happens when they act in their stead? Let's pay attention. Shall be equal to the face value of direct obligations of the United States or when issued against the security of notes, drafts, bills of exchange, bankers' acceptances acquired under the provisions of this act. The amount thereof shall be equal to not more than 90% of the estimated value of such notes, drafts, bills of exchange, bankers' acceptances, so deposited as security. You gave a security deposit, people. That's why you pay the other 10%. 90% plus 10% is 100%. Such notes shall be obligations of the Federal Reserve Bank procuring the same. When it says the Federal Reserve Bank, it's talking about the actual member bank of the Federal Reserve or the national bank, not you. When it says the, it's being specific. When it says any, it is being general. It means any bank. Give us a second. We're going to explain that. Now, shall be receivable at par, equal value, in all parts of the United States, all parts, that's including territories, for the same purposes as national banknotes. National banknotes are circulating notes of the Federal Reserve. National banknotes still exist, but they are not used in our economy anymore. But they still exist, and they are considered legal tender. For the same purposes, go ahead and look up our national banknotes legal tender, and you'll see that they're legal tender. So your junk is the same purpose as a national banknote, and shall be redeemable in lawful money of the United States upon presentation to the United States Treasury or at the bank of issue. Not the bank of issuing of the promissory note, but the bank of issuance of the notes. National bank notes are Federal Reserve notes, because national bank notes are now Federal Reserve notes. That's why it's for the same purposes as that note. So, ladies and gentlemen, stop arguing with these people. Stop trying to prove that you don't owe no money. Don't say you don't owe them a dime. Say you've already paid. You've already tendered payment. Now, we told you we were going to show you something, so give us a second so that we can show you a little something, because y'all got to see this in order to believe it. Hey, Natalie, thank you for inseparable. Okay, you know what, Whitney Houston? I might get in trouble for this, y'all. We ain't going to play Whitney. And no, because if I play, y'all need to understand, if I play Whitney, they gonna definitely block this video. Ain't no error occurred. Y'all better keep going. There you go. The error occurred because we got ad blockers. We don't play that. Now, let me show y'all something. We can go to Federal Reserve Act. DefinitionIONS. We want to go to the definition section because you do need to know what the definition of what is, or you'll never understand. Well, we just can't face it. We've gotten to that point, y'all. But some of us have got to what? That we just can't what? We're going to go to section one, short title and definition, so that you guys understand what's going on. Neither one of us wants to be the first to say goodbye. No, go. Goodbye. No, I didn't had enough of you. Go. Nuh-uh, shut up. Nuh-uh, goodbye. 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 Talk to the hand. Talk to the hand. I apologize, ladies and gentlemen. We should have been at that page by now, so apparently someone wants you guys to see. Section 1, short title of the Federal Reserve Act. Okay, somebody is trying to prevent y'all from seeing Section 1 of the short title. So what you need to do is all this stuff in brackets, that's not part of the act. So ignore that junk. Okay, everything in brackets, this 12 USC blah blah blah, that's not part of the act. So ignore that junk. So let's pay attention. Being enacted by the House, Senate and House of Representatives of the United States of America and Congress assembled, that the short title for the act is Federal Reserve Act. That's the short title. Now, that's the second thing. Whenever the word bank, doesn't matter if it's preceded by federal, state, or any other word, whenever the word bank is used in the act, the word shall be held to include, pay attention, state banks, banking associations, trust companies. Now, hold on, here's an exception. See, only the exception is the exception, except when national banks and Federal Reserve banks are specifically referred to, as in the Federal Reserve, a Federal Reserve bank. But any Federal Reserve bank is not specific. Any means any. Let's go ahead and prove that. For the purposes of this act, a state bank includes any bank which is operating under the code or the laws of the District of Columbia. Ladies and gentlemen, we are all operating under the code of law of the District of Columbia. Every bank is in a district because the Federal Reserve is situated in the District of Columbia. No, we're not finished yet. Remember, include doesn't necessarily exclude unless it's specific as to what it excludes. So whenever it says National Bank or Federal Reserve Bank specifically, then it is not included. Give me a second. I have to send this person a text message letting them know that I'll call them back. Because I don't want to ignore them. And they'll know that I'll call them right back. Now, let's get back to our bank conversation. Pay attention. Includes doesn't necessarily mean exclude unless it is specific that it excludes something. We learned that the other day, didn't we? So whenever doing statutory interpretation, include does not necessarily mean exclude unless the exception is written in the statute. Here's the exception. The word bank doesn't matter. If the word bank, because when you add another word to it, it becomes a term. So Federal Reserve Bank, National Bank, those are terms, not words. Okay? So the word bank, when used in the act, refers to any bank, including national banks and Federal Reserve banks. However, the word bank doesn't necessarily refer to the Federal Reserve Bank or the National Bank of the Federal Reserve because it's specific. So let's go ahead and deal with terms now. You see how bank is associated with another word? Now it's a term. The terms National Bank and National Banking Association used in this act shall be held to be synonymous, interchangeable with the term member bank. See, we added another word to bank, so now it's a term. And it shall be held to mean any. Uh-oh. Pay attention. Any national bank, any state bank, any bank, any trust company which has become a member of one of the reserve banks created by this act. When you are conducting banking business, you are a member of the Reserve Bank. Go ahead. Presidential Proclamation 2039 says a bank is anyone engaged in the business of banking. So, let's go back to make sure y'all understand what's going on here. Such notes shall be obligations of the Federal, see, the Federal Reserve Bank, that the makes it specific. So this is the Federal Reserve Bank. However, pay attention, or at the bank of issue. Pay attention. There's a difference there. It's statutory interpretation, people. This is not in English. So stop reading it as if it's English. Now, let's cover something else because some of y'all need to understand this because some of y'all just don't get it. But he didn't get far. He found out the hard way that dreams that somehow they somehow don't always come true. No. I don't know how he can climb on hopes, ladies and gentlemen, because hopes seem a little bit difficult to climb on. The last section of the bill, the Federal Reserve Act Amendment of March 9, 1933, provides for the issuance of a new money. That's right. They took your gold. They had to give you remedy. They took your money, people. Gold should not coin anything but gold and silver as money in the United States. Pay attention. So guess what? Sorry. It's first thing in the morning. And this is an allergy season for me. It's not a bad allergy season, but it has been an interesting allergy season. Anyway, the last section of the bill provides for the issuance of a new money. Now, let's talk about this new money. Because you're not going to hear about the new money once. You're going to hear about this new money twice. How is it to be handled? So they gave instructions as to how the new money is to be handled. Now, he's referring to Section 401. Let's go to Section 401 and let's read it. Because we don't want to skip Section 401. Okay, Section 401 of Title 4 of the Federal Reserve Act, subsection 18, paragraph number 6. Go ahead, it's still there. It ain't gone nowhere. Upon deposit with the Treasury of the United States, of any direct obligation of the United States, or of any notes, drafts, bills of exchange, banking substances acquired under the provisions of this act. Now, it says direct obligation. Let's find out what direct obligation means. Okay, so it says Section 401. We read Section 401. Let's go over here. I refer to Section 401, which reads, upon deposit with the Treasury of the United States of America, all contract obligations. Whoa, it didn't say contract up there, did it? Ah, but they're telling you what it means. All contract obligations of the United States or any notes, drafts, bills of exchange, banking acceptance, and so forth under the Federal Reserve Act. The Federal Reserve Act we just talked about being amended. Obligations, contracts, obligations that are deposited as security, promissory notes or contract obligations. Shh, don't tell nobody. And gold, so they're deposited as the security and gold. That's right, the new money. Remember the Constitution said what money was and how money was to be construed? Well, now they just redefined what the new money was. For reserve notes are placed in the hands of Federal Reserve agents. Then he says, this provision is for the issuance of Federal Reserve banknotes. These are your national banknotes, ladies and gentlemen. National banknotes. No longer do they issue national banknotes. And not for Federal Reserve notes. Now, as of June 12, 1945, they issue national banknotes. Ladies and gentlemen, I can't do the same song twice. Give me a second. I love my Gladys. Y'all know how much I love my Gladys. That's my girl. But Gladys, this song and us, we're not going to make it. We got to go to the next song. Apologize for that, y'all. Just my imagination. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, y'all just don't understand how much it's just my imagination. Oh, no. No, that's neither one of us. I want my imagination. Oh, that's the I thought that was the song coming on. That's the album cover. No, we've already did leaving on that midnight train. Okay, we need my imagination. Hopefully I can get my imagination. I can get my imagination if I just use my imagination and go on down. Nah, this is the Commodores. I won't be able to get my imagination. I'm going to have to listen to my imagination later. Getting back to the conversation, ladies and gentlemen. Pay attention. It says, not Federal Reserve notes. The Act of June 12, 1945 changed this. Now it is Federal Reserve notes. And the security backed of it is the contractual obligations, the promissory notes, the Federal Reserve notes, the national bank notes, any notes, drafts, bills of exchange, bankers' acceptances outlined in the section which the gentleman has referred. So let's go to the section and let's make sure of what it means by notes. I begged, stole, and I borrowed, y'all. Any notes, not just promissory notes. Not just national bank notes, not just Federal Reserve notes, any notes, ladies and gentlemen, any notes. So, why are you guys arguing with these people, these lawyers, these judges? Why are you arguing with these companies? Ladies and gentlemen, it lets you know that when you deliver that promissory note to the Federal Reserve, such notes are obligations of the Federal Reserve Bank that receives it. So when you delivered your promissory note to whomever you were making the arrangement with for the purchase, then they were supposed to give it to the Federal Reserve. The Federal Reserve were supposed to receive notes from the Treasury. That's what this section speaks about. The Secretary of the Treasury is authorized and empowered to prescribe regulations governing the issuance, redemption, replacement, retirement, and destruction of such circulating notes, and to release the substitution of security thereof. And the release and substitution of security thereof. Okay, the Treasury does that. Okay, hold on. Let's make sure that you guys understand about circulating notes, because now they're Federal Reserve notes. It says, any Federal Reserve Bank making a deposit in the manner prescribed by the Secretary of the Treasury shall be entitled to receive from the Comptroller of the Currency circulating notes in blank, or, pay attention, Federal Reserve notes, duly registered and countersigned. You are entitled. That's what Section 414 says. Ladies and gentlemen, finally, this wasn't supposed to be a 30-minute video, but some of y'all need to see it. Let's go. We can go to Section 16, because that's Section 414 of Title 12. Oh! Ow! Ow! Ladies and gentlemen, granting right to issue notes. You see, this is where they receive the authority of the Treasury. The Board of Governors of the Federal Reserve System shall have the right, acting through the Federal Reserve agent, to grant in whole or in part, or to reject entirely the application of any Federal Reserve Bank. See, the Federal Reserve agent, any Federal Reserve Bank, for Federal Reserve notes. But to the extent that such an application is granted, you've been approved. The Board of Governors of the Federal Reserve System, the Board of Governors of the Federal Reserve System, shall, through its local Federal Reserve agent, supply Federal Reserve notes to the banks, plural, meaning any bank so applying. There you go. That's the whole process, people. It is not more complicated than that. Stop making it complicated. Stop arguing. So, we're going to be starting up the new program. I'll be talking about it over the next couple of weeks. The fact is, we're trying to get it, but I think we're going to go up to $400,000 worth of debt initially, because that means that you can have up to 3 accounts, up to $400,000 worth of debt. We're going to be doing it under the AmeriLegion program, which is already set up to do something similar, but not this. This is not the same program with AmeriLegion. This is different because this includes other information where we do it under the EeoN Foundation. So if there is a need for a court matter, then you have the assistance in that matter because there will be a contract worked out so that he, that sole proprietor, can go in and speak on behalf of your agreement with him and how the other party is interfering by bringing a fraudulent claim. Again, we'll explain all of this in the future. Have a good day, everybody. 29 minutes just giving you the information we think you need. We'll talk to you shortly. Do not inquire, do not ask about, do not email, because you will not get a response. Goodbye, everyone.